Welcome to In 5 Minutes. We'll go for next type of selection statement. It is if else if statement. We already done a statement if else, where if a condition is satisfied, then some statement A works, otherwise statement B works. So if the condition is not satisfied, the other statement will always work, whatever the other conditions can be. Now in some cases, we have to put condition for all the group of statements. There can be multiple statements, let's say A, B, C, and for each statement there will be some conditions to be checked. Now such kind of statements are written with multiple if else if. Let's see the simple form of statement. The first one we see over here is if condition 1 is true, then statement 1 works, else if the condition 2 is true, then statement 2 works. So it is not like if else, where if condition is satisfied, statement 1 works, else 2 will work. There is no guarantee that statement 2 will work. So here, if condition 1 is satisfied, statement 1 will work, second part will be simply skipped. But if the condition 1 is false, then program will check whether the condition 2 is true. If that is found true, then only statement 2 will work. So either statement 1 or statement 2 will work, otherwise both will be skipped. For example, condition 1 is true, statement 1 will work. If false and condition 2 is true, then statement 2 will work. If both the condition 1 and 2 are false, statement 1 and 2 both will be skipped. Now, its general example is as shown in the next syntax. We can add multiple conditions and with them we can put multiple statements. It is read like if condition 1 is true, then execute statement 1. Else if condition 2 is true, then execute statement 2. Else if condition 3 is true, then execute statement 3, and so on. We can go on writing multiple if else if conditions. At the end, if we want, we can put else statement for some statement 4. That is, if none of the conditions is found true, then only statement 4 works. But that else part is not compulsory. We can write only multiple if else if conditions. Now let's see a typical example. We'll assume that condition 2 was true and others were false. From top, program will start working. We'll reach the first if statement. The condition is false, so we'll skip statement 1, go to else if statement. Here we'll check the condition 2. Since it is found true, we'll enter into the next second if statement, execute statement 2. Then it will simply skip all the statements after that which are in the if else, and then continue with the rest of the statements. So the program starts working from top, reaches if else statement, whichever condition is found first true from top, that part of the statement works, and remaining else and else if statements will be simply skipped without even checking the conditions. It may happen that condition 2 and condition 3 both are true, but from top, since it finds first this condition 2 is true, the execute statement 2 without checking, you will just go down and execute the remaining part of the program. So that is how a typical if else if works. Let's see one small example to understand this concept. We'll be writing a program to input a number and check whether the number is a positive number, a negative number, or zero. So there are three possibilities. So here we'll write printf scanf command to input a number. We are assuming variable name as a. Here we'll put a condition: if the number a is greater than zero, then obviously it's a positive number. Then in that case, we printf a positive number. Else, can we say it's a negative number directly? No. We have to again check whether a is less than 0. Then only it will be a negative number. Then let over it's a negative number. Else, because either it will be positive or it will be negative, otherwise it will be obviously 0. So for that we can put else. Here we need not check whether else if it is 0 or not, because if it is not positive, it is not negative, number will be a 0. So here we write 0. Now the program works typically. Program start, variable a is defined. Suppose the input number scanf was 5, then program check if a is greater than 0, true. So you'll output positive number and remaining else will be simply skipped. The other way it can work is program will start. Suppose we input the value as 0. We'll check for is a greater than 0, false. So if is skipped, else if a is less than 0, again false will be skipped and probability will be 0. So that is the result of multiple if else if statements. Thank you.